Hello, here is my review of my Goldenfir 512GB SSD from AliExpress. The store I bought it from is the Goldenfir SSD store, which is too new to have its own feedback profile yet. Yet Goldenfir as a brand have been around a while. I've been tempted by their prices for the last 5 years on AliExpress. I follow the SAS of one cable from Mobo to Goldenfir disk. The Windows disk is a Kingston, safely tucked into its own alcove. We have 4 disk ports total, 3 SATA, 1 M2. The M2 is occupied but disabled because it's Linux, and Windows, if it sees a Linux disk, will probably do something not very nice to it. Crystal disk mark is underway and I've sped this up. I have nothing else hogging the PC. I hope this conveys the high performance available to the empty drive. I do have a longer test that I performed on it, the H2 test, W test. It went on for about 5 hours. Crystal disk mark will always be the first test I run on a disk, once basic connectivity is established. It doesn't prove anything other than the maximum speed. As we see with H2 test W, solid state disk performance rapidly degrades from this best case performance. More reputable brands will include a guaranteed minimum speed. This often comes at a huge premium, as there is a triangle of competing priorities: speed, longevity, and price. Speed and longevity are limited by current technology. Once that technology has provided a return on investment, it can be bought very cheaply. Notice how we're not comparing like with like here. Goldenfir have gone with a 8-year-old version of Crystal Disk Mark. Even the test names have changed. I wasn't going to record the whole 6-hour test. As the ETA got pushed back, I recorded less and less. The snapshots can provide data of just how performance degrades as the disk fills. It starts off recording, it's going really fast, and then it just gets slower and slower, and the time remaining just goes up and up. So it looks like you're going to get it done in half an hour. Don't believe a word of it. It'll take 4 hours, and it's not just Goldenfir that does this. I haven't seen a drive that doesn't do it. They start off fast, and then they get slow. If they start off faster than the specification allows, then you'd be suspicious. H2 test W fills the disk completely with pseudo-random data in such a way that a manufacturer couldn't yet anticipate this and cheat. I calculated that filling the disk completely is equivalent to 0.2% of its write capacity. TBW, terabytes written. Goldenfir haven't given a TBW here. Just a 3-year warranty, which probably won't be worth the postage. Just remember bathtub failure curves. If it doesn't fail in 15 days, it probably won't fail for at least 15 more months. Once the drive is populated with test data, it can be verified quickly and cheaply. I leave this data on it for a few days before using the drive in anger. As the test concludes, I've panned down to my machine just to show the same Goldenfir drive in place. You have no reason to doubt me, but warranty handlers might have had it failed. H2 test W is a tough test. I'm not concerned by the USB 2 speed seen at the end. I'm not going to try to explain those in this short video. It's a little disappointing, but I've not run H2 test W on a locally sourced, reputable brand. There's no need to lose that 0.2% of write endurance when there's a 3 or 5 year warranty. Write once, verify twice is the equivalent to measure twice and cut once. Test completed at 5:15, 6 hours after starting. Using the figures obtained from the clips, I've plotted write speed against disk utilisation in gigabytes filled. You can see that speed falls off a cliff at about 25% full, or 100 gigabytes. With USB sticks, I don't really feel them more than 25%, so this might not be a problem. The poor speeds above 50% usage could be a problem if they were persistent, but because this was an intense writing session, non-stop writing, the disk or the operating system didn't get a chance to do any housekeeping that it might do in real-world usage, where the disk is always on, unlike a portable device. I can't offer a better explanation of why performance falls off a cliff like this, but I gather it's pretty common, and it is ubiquitous in what I've observed in running H2 test W. All the disks I've tested have done this. Some fail afterwards. If they don't fail, then it's a good sign that you've at least got 100 gigabyte of fast disk. The rest is reliable too. what the operating system might be doing is shuffling less used data onto slower storage, if that's the reason why it slows after the first 100 have been written. H2TestW is the golden standard of testing disks. I used to use fake flash test, or the superior Linux alternative, fight fake flash. Fake flash test always defers to H2TestW at the end. Fake flash test performs a destructive test that admits it is not conclusive. I've seen both false negatives and false positives with it. I believe this drive failed, actually,